We are 2 days away from the 2015 Rose Bowl, and today the focus was on Marcus Mariota and the Oregon offense. KZI 9 Sports Director Jake Zivin is down in Los Angeles with more of our continuing Rose Bowl coverage presented by Bi-Mart. And Jake, I heard people comparing quarterbacks today, but it was not Mariota and Jameis Winston. Tell us more.
Right, Matt. Yesterday, a Florida State linebacker, Reggie Northrup, said that he thinks that FSU is prepared for Oregon because their scout team quarterback is faster than Marcus Mariota. That scout team quarterback is named John Franklin. He's a redshirt freshman, is essentially the third team QB. And I'll give him this, he is fast. He's a sprinter on the FSU track team. He made the finals of the ACC championships in the 100 meters, ran 10.72 at that event. Tracktown fans will understand what that means. So his speed is legitimate. But still, when FSU talks about it, it seems like they're discrediting Marcus.
Oh yeah, I think that's true. I mean, him in the game won't be like John Franklin is in practice. I feel like John Franklin, one of the fastest players in the country, and he run track, so I mean, I don't think it's comparable.
People say how fast Oregon is, but our team across the board has tremendous speed. I mean, from every position. So, I mean, for him to be one of the fastest people on our team, that says something about him. So, I don't know. You'd have to see them in a foot race, but I believe he might have a step or two on Mariota.
Well, Duck fans aren't going to like hearing that, and Mariota's teammates also don't like it. They, of course, came to the Heisman winner's defense.
Yeah, I was about to say, I've never seen a dude play. He's a backup, so who knows? And if he's faster than Marcus, you feel me, hats off to him. But Marcus is a hell of a player. You can't really simulate that in practice.
Maybe he should have played this year more then. I mean, if he's faster and he's a better quarterback, maybe he should have stepped in a little bit more.
I know there's a lot of fast guys at Florida State, but I definitely pit Marcus up against him, and we'll see. You know, we'll see what, you know, with the combine coming around, we'll see how fast he really is.
So, like I said, Franklin ran a 10.72 in the 100-meter dash. Devin Allen, who obviously knows a thing or two about track, estimated that if Marcus was able to train for a month, he could get sub 10.5. As for Allen himself, if he just ran in a straight line and didn't have to jump over things, he could go 10.2 in the 100 meters. And guys, as you can probably tell, it's raining here in Los Angeles. It's about 45 degrees out. I know it's colder in Eugene right now, but at the least, the Ducks have to feel at home here in L.A. FSU, not so much, not enjoying this colder weather than at least they are used to. Live in downtown Los Angeles, I'm Jake Zivin, KEZI 9 Sports.
Speaking a little bit cold, a little bit wet today, Sports Director Jake Zivin. But the focus on Marcus Mariota today in Los Angeles as he and his offensive teammates took the podium. And again, KZI 9 Sports Director Jake Zivin live in downtown Los Angeles with a little bit wet shoulders, but he also has more of our continuing Rose Bowl coverage presented by Bi-Mart. And Jake, the Ducks not too happy with the national perception of their team.
Yeah, Matt, first of all, as you mentioned, it is raining and 40 degrees here, so we feel like home in downtown Los Angeles, a little bit of Oregon for us in Southern California. And yeah, as you mentioned, apparently on the other side of the country, there's still a perception that the Ducks are a finesse team, a soft team. Now, I don't think Florida State thinks that. You'll hear from their defensive coordinator in a moment, but their fans and the media that cover them certainly seem to feel that way. The Ducks were asked about that today and got pretty fired up.
kind of that, just chuckle and laugh. You want to downplay our game, feel free, but we're still going to come out and we're still going to play our hardest. Sometimes that's not good enough. Majority of the time it is. We'll guarantee you that we'll play hard.
I mean, I don't know where y'all people getting your facts from. Where this talk, all this talk from, oh, they're not physical, they're a finesse team. Like, we're fast and we're spread out, but we can play with anybody. I don't know where you guys are coming up with this.
People assume because you spread the field out that you're finesse. That's not true. They run the football as good as anybody. I mean, they move people. You know, to me, finesse is just throwing the ball in the perimeter all the time.
That was Florida State's defensive coordinator, Charles Kelly, Charles Kelly is, of course, the real name of Chip Kelly. His first name is Charles, a pretty crazy coincidence. And coming up in about 15 minutes, we will have more on Oregon's practice. We were inside of their practice today. Thomas Tyner, Ronis Grassu, both participating. Both should be good to go in the Rose Bowl. We'll also let you know what Florida State's defense had to say about facing Marcus Mariota and the Duck offense, how they think they can stop the Heisman Trophy winner. Live in a rainy downtown Los Angeles, I'm Jake Zivin. Matt, back to you. Steady rain, temperatures in the 40s. Feels like Oregon, not Los Angeles, but we are live in downtown L.A. tonight for our continuing coverage of the 2015 Rose Bowl presented by Bi-Mart. I'm Jake Zivin. The other member of our team down here in Southern California is Mike Scow. We start with him tonight and a look at how Florida State plans to defend Marcus Mariota.
Tuesday brought us back for the second and final look into Oregon's practice during this Rose Bowl trip, which began with the Seminoles' war chant being pumped through the sound system. Florida State's defensive players say their scout team quarterback's speed has helped them prepare for Marcus Mariota, but there is no doubt they will have their hands full when they face the Heisman winner.
I've watched him on tape just flat out outrun people, and to be able to contain his speed and his athleticism is a big factor.
Just not tipping off where you're going to be, you know, before the play, because he's the type of quarterback who can read coverages, who can get pre-snap reads, and just being disciplined, basically.
His ability to extend plays and get out of the pocket, and, you know, he's not just a runner or a scrambler. He keeps his eyes downfield and can make a big play at any given moment. So it's definitely going to be kind of tough to contain an athlete like him.
Florida State defensive coordinator Charles Kelly emphasized the Seminoles need to be ready for Oregon's up-tempo offense and expects the Ducks to be crafty with their play calling.
Of course, they've had, more time to prepare for this game, so I'm sure that they've got some wrinkles that we haven't seen before. I think the number one challenge is it's hard to replicate that in practice. The speed of it is something that, we try, and our scout team has done an unbelievable job.
A couple notes from the Ducks practice. Both Ronis Grassu and Thomas Tyner look to be full participants, taking plenty of snaps during the 15 minutes we were allowed in practice. Charles Nelson was also on the field with the team a couple days after we saw him on a separate field after we had a chance to see the Ducks during their first practice. At the StubHub Center, Mike Scow, KZI 9 Sports.
Thanks a lot, Mike. So something about bowl week seems to always bring out color from players that we don't get to see normally back in Eugene. Maybe it's the massive amount of media in attendance, the wide variety of questions, the bright lights in their face. But today, Jake Fisher decided to use his spot on the podium to stump for his head coach.
Do you think he's the most underappreciated coach maybe in this playoff this year?
The most underpaid, yes.
For sure, yeah.
When in L.A., bust out your inner Ari Gold, I suppose. Naturally, we had to follow up and hear from Fisher about what he thinks his head coach should be making.
He should be one of the most highest paid coaches in college football, especially with all the money being paid out at Michigan, Alabama, and all those big schools. I feel like he should at least contest with those numbers.
One coach making more than Mark Helfrich, Mike Riley at Nebraska, $2.7 million. And he's getting the gang back together. His former offensive coordinator, Danny Langsdorf, is rejoining him in Lincoln as the OC of the Cornhuskers. Langsdorf was the offensive coordinator at Oregon State from 2005 to 2013 before leaving to spend this past season as the New York Giants quarterbacks coach. There are now 8 former Beaver assistants with Riley in Nebraska. Back here in Los Angeles tomorrow, the head coaches take the stage for one final press conference before the game, Jimbo Fisher and Mark Helfrich. We will hear from them. And on KEZI 9 News tomorrow at 5 and 6:30, we will chat live with Nick Aliotti, the legendary Oregon defensive coordinator. I know you want to hear what he has to say about this game. Be sure to tune in tomorrow evening. Live in downtown Los Angeles, I'm Jake Zivin, KEZI 9 Sports.